I'm Tina McDonald, part of Spellbinder's Inspiration Team. Today we're going to be creating a Happy Birthday Rosette card using some of my favorite product from the Celebrations collection. Begin with a piece of white cardstock. We're going to be taking the pierced rectangles, dies number 3 and 4, and nest them together over the white cardstock. We're going to hold it in place with a piece of low-tack tape, and we're going to be die cutting this, but we're going to wait. Right now, we're going to do some stamping for our sentiment. We're going to be using the Your Day set and the Happy Birthday from that set. We're going to be stamping using the Captivating Coral. So go ahead and ink up your stamp, and we'll stamp that right up onto the white cardstock as well. Now we're going to take one of the stamps from the Tape It set, and we're going to be stamping it above and below our sentiment. And we're going to be using the Cotton Candy for this. So go ahead and ink up our stamp. This one is very light, so it's going to be very faint. So we're going to go above the sentiment, and then we're also going to go below. We're going to die cut our sentiment using the pierced ovals die number 2, and then nest die number 1 inside, which has the pierced element. Then cut and emboss this as we did previously. Use the True Color Fusion Stamp Cleaner and a rag to clean up your stamps super quick. Now trim the white cardstock so you're not using an excess and set this aside. Next, we're going to take a small piece of the light pink cardstock, which would be the cotton candy, and we're going to be die cutting the smallest rosette bloom from this piece. And we'll also use die number 2 from the pierced rectangle set and cut out this pretty green paper from the assorted prints. We're going to die cut all of this together using the Grand Caliber machine, so place them on your base plate covered by your cutting plate and run it through your machine. To emboss, remove the cutting plate and replace it with the tan embossing mat and the pink embossing plate, and once again run it through your machine. Now we're going to want a second piece of the die number 2 from the pierced rectangles, so we're going to use the pink polka dot paper from the assorted prints, and we also want a second rosette onto that light pink cotton candy paper. So go ahead and cut and emboss those once again. Now that we have all our pieces prepared, we can start to assemble our card. Prepare your cardstock base using the cotton candy, and then we're going to remove the die templates from your pierced rectangle, and we're going to adhere it to the front of our cardstock base. Now adhere the two pieces of the pierced rectangles together, slightly askew so that they're slightly tilted from each other. And then we're going to use the linen thread in the light green, and we're going to wrap it around twice and tie a nice little bow on the left-hand side. Now adhere this to the front panel of our card using foam tape. We're going to do the same thing to our sentiment. We're going to adhere it to the front of our card as well using foam tape. Now take the two rosette blooms and trim the little piece there that's still adjoining them at the tip. And then we're going to fold these in an accordion style. You'll see all the lines are already scored when we did our embossing. So go ahead and fold back and forth until both pieces are prepared like this. Now we're going to adhere them together, tucking one inside the other, and we're going to use a wet adhesive to help hold them in place. Once it's dry, we're going to add a pretty little flower center using a foam square. So add the foam square to the center of your flower and then add the gem over top of it. I wanted to add a little touch of contrasting color to the outside of my bloom, so I'm using the Captivating Coral and a foam dauber here just to add a little bit of ink to the edges of my flower. Then this is ready to adhere to our card. Thanks for tuning in today. I love to hear your feedback, so please feel free to like this video and leave any comments or questions in the space provided below. Also, don't forget to follow the Spellbinders Paper Arts YouTube channel. Thanks again for watching. Have a great day.